I live in New York now. I love living in New York. It's hard being a basketball fan in New York, though, because it's so expensive if you want to go to a game. If you want to go to a Knicks game, it's like $200. Lucky for me, my brother moved to D.C., so once a year I go visit him. We go to a Wizards game, because it's like 75 cents to go see the Wizards, right? Nobody gives a shit. You can pay $5 at a Wizards game, and you can sit on the court at half court while they're playing. That's how much nobody gives a shit about the Wizards. You guys know the t-shirt guns they have at basketball games? They blast t-shirts into the crowd of these high-powered air guns. Went to a Wizards game last year. They came out with these air guns at halftime. The announcer got in the loudspeaker and goes, "Who would like a free Chipotle burrito?" And then they started blasting burritos into the stands with the air gun. And they have a Chipotle in the stadium, so it's like a marketing thing for them. If you were to ask me, hey, what's the worst thing you can think of to blast into 19,000 people? Like, I wouldn't even think of burrito. Burrito's two things beyond what I would think of. I'd be like, beans, fill it with beans. That's a bad idea. Salsa, that's very messy. It's gonna get all over everybody. I wouldn't even think to take all the burrito ingredients, wrap them up into an actual burrito form, stuff them in a gun, and blast that into the crowd. I wouldn't think to do that. But if you're in that crowd, you want that burrito, right? That burrito is like $20 at an NBA basketball game, and that burrito beats the shit out of a foul ball at a baseball game any day. If I was at a baseball game standing next to like an 8-year-old kid and his dad, and I caught a foul ball, I would give it to the 8-year-old kid. That ball means more to the kid than it does to me. That same kid standing next to me at a basketball game, if he caught a burrito, I would beat the shit out of that kid. I would eat the burrito in front of him and his father. I would do that. That's how great it is. When there's a burrito spiraling towards you and you're in the upper deck, that's a great moment. That's a happy time. That moment turns bad very quickly when that burrito starts unraveling. Your whole section is rained on by wet, hot burrito ingredients. What if you're vegan? What if you're a vegan and you're in seats that you paid for and you're covered in sour cream and steak? That's horrifying. My favorite player growing up was Dikembe Mutombo. Do you guys know who that is? Yeah, he did the finger wag, that's right. Yeah, every time he blocked a shot, he'd wave his finger in the opponent's face. It's really cool when he did it. I realize it's weirdly effeminate when I do it. Not nearly as cool when I do it. If you know nothing about basketball though, Dikembe Mutombo is my favorite player based on name alone, okay? His full name is Dikembe Mutombo Polanda Mukamba Jean-Jacques Mutombo. That's his full name. Sure, it's funny because it's different. And he's got two sons. He named his first son Dikembe Mutombo Polanda Mukamba Jean-Jacques Mutombo Jr., all right? And I'll try to pronounce his second son's name for you and not stumble over it. Ryan. Feel like he's playing favorites. Family name is skewed way over to the first kid. I feel sorry for Ryan. You know, Ryan gets stuck doing all the chores in that house. In that house, it's a lot of, I need someone to mow the lawn. Dikembe Mutombo, f*** it. Ryan!